Assalamu alaikum and good day to all of my students. Today, you will learn chapter 2, descriptive statistics. So here is the content in chapter 2. So 2.1, measures of central tendency. 2.2, measures of variation. 2.3, measures of position. And 2.4, descriptive statistics using Excel. So here is some reviews on descriptive statistics. So descriptive statistics is typically used to confirm conjectures about the data. So we can summarize data using measures of central tendency, measures of variation, and measures of position. So we have three parts here. Okay, first one is central tendency, second is variation, and the third one is a position. So some classify these type of measures as traditional statistics. So if the measurement describes about a population characteristic, it's called a parameter. Okay, so parameter for population and statistic is for sample. So rule of thumb for decimal places. So in general, the calculated parameter or statistic value should be rounded to 4 decimal places. So if the unit is given, for example, in centimeter, minutes or day, the value should be rounded to that unit's decimal places. So we go 2.1, measures of central tendency. So under measures of central tendency, you need to calculate. The first one is mean, second is median, third is mode, and fourth is mid-range. So the measures of central tendency are used to describe an entire set of observation with a single value representing the central or middle value of the data set. Okay, so we look one by one here, the formula for mid-range. So what is a mid-range? So mid-range is a rough estimate of the middle. So the formula for mid-range is x mean plus x max divided by 2. So x mean is the lowest value and x max is the highest value. Okay? So look at the example. So find the mid-range of the data set. So we have 2, 3, 6, 8, 4, and 1. So the lowest value is 1, so this is x mean, and the highest value is 8, so this is x max. So we put this number into the formula, so 1 plus 8 divided by 2, we'll get 4.5. Okay, so we go to the mean. So mean is the sum of the values divided by the total number of values. Okay, so here we have two formula. First one, population, and second one for sample. Okay, so population, okay, the symbol for mean, as I mentioned before this, population mean is a mu, one for the population, sorry, one for the sample mean is a x bar. Okay, so here is the formula for the population, and this one formula for the sample. So we look at the example. Okay, find the population mean and sample mean for this data. Okay, so we have this data. Okay, you need to sum up all the data and divide by the total number of sample for population, or divide by the total number of sample if that one is a mean for sample. So in this case, okay, so the population is equal to 9. So same to the sample size. So n is also equal to 9. So that's why we get the same value here. Okay, so descriptive statistic can be obtained by using the scientific calculator. Okay, so this one we will discuss deeply in our online class. Okay, so we go to the median. Median is the middle number of n ordered data from smallest to largest. So that means before you find the median, you need to order your data from smallest to largest. This one's very important. Okay, so we have two formula for the median. First one, if n is odd number. If the sample size is odd number, another one is if n is even number. Okay, so look at the example below. Okay, so find the median of the data set 4, 3, 1, 2, 5. So n here equal to 5. 5 is a odd number. So by using the formula, so x 5 divided by 2, you will get x 2.5. So since we get the decimal places here, we round up, then you get x 3. So we ordered data, so it become 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So x 3 means that the third number. So the third number equal to 3. So this one equal to 3. So this is the answer. Okay, look at the second example here. So here n equal to 6. 6 is even number. Okay, so even number. So we use this formula. So x 6 divided by 2 plus x 6 divided by 2 plus 1 divided by 2. Then we will get x 3 plus x 4 divided by 2. Okay, then x 3 is equal to 3, x 4 equal to 4. So divided by 2, we'll get 3 points. Okay, the properties of mean and median. So we have several properties of mean and median, but I want to highlight some important thing here. The first point here, okay, the mean is unique and not necessarily one of the data values. So when you calculate the mean, it doesn't mean that number is one of the data value in your sample size, in your sample data. Okay, so the mean is used in computing other statistics such as variance. So later on, you'll see in variance, we need to calculate mean first. Okay, before we get the value for the variance. Okay, and then another one is the mean is not appropriate average. Okay, to use if the shape of distribution is skewed. Okay, this one is very important. For the median, so median is used when one must find the center or middle values of data set. Okay, and the median is affected less than the mean by extremely high or extremely low values. So if we have the data that extremely high or extremely low values, so the median is the best one compared to the mean. Okay, so we look at the mode. So what is a mode? Values that occurs most frequently in a data set. The highest frequency. Okay, we look at the example here. So if the data set are 163785, okay, so then the mode is not exist. Okay, because all of this number appear once only. Okay, but for the B, so if data set are 163785, so when you see the number of 3 here, it appear twice, okay, compared to other number, then the mode is 3. Okay, the last one, C. So if data set are 163738757, okay, so number 3, okay, and number 7. Okay, so then the mode is 3 and 7. So mode can be not exist, mode can be only one, and it also can be more than one. So we have exercise 2.1 here. So I want you to do this exercise. So as usual, later on in our class online, okay, we will discuss this. Okay, then We look at the measures of strength, central tendency for group data. So previously, okay, that one is for ungrouped data. Okay, this one for group data. So actually, okay, for group data, this one is just for your additional knowledge. Okay, in our syllabus, we did not focus on the group data. We just focus on the ungrouped data. So this one just for your additional knowledge. You can read it, okay, and go through, okay, the formula and also the example we give you, okay. So we also give you the solution here, so you can go through one by one, okay. I will not discuss this deeply because in our syllabus, we just focus on the ungrouped data, okay. So I want to discuss about the shape of distribution, measures of central tendency, okay. So the measures of central tendency, from the measures of central tendency, so we can know the shape of distribution, okay. If you have these three information, mean, median and mode, okay. So if you have these three information, you can know which shape of distribution of that data. Okay, for example, the first one. So if the median is less than, if the mean less than median and less than mode, that one is a left skewed distribution. Okay, so you just compare these three values. But if the mode less than median and less than mean, that one is a right skewed distribution. Okay. And the third one, if you get the same value for the mean, median, and mode, we can conclude that data is a symmetric, okay, symmetrical distribution, okay. So look at example 2.3, okay. So determine the type of distribution of the following data, okay. So if you get this data, so before we conclude what type of the distribution, we need to calculate mean, median, and mode. These three. Okay? Before we compare, we need to calculate these three. Okay, look at the solution here. Okay. So for number one, we calculate mean, we get 12.88, median 13.05, and mode 13.3. So since median is less, since the mean is less than median and the median is less than mode, so the type of distribution is left skewed distribution. Okay. For number 2, 3, and 4, the values for mean, median, and mode are given, right? So you don't need to calculate, just compare it. So since the value for mean, median, and mode are same, okay, so that is a symmetrical distribution. So number 3, okay, mode less than median and median is less than mean. So we can conclude that one is a right skewed. Okay, and the last one, so mean less than median and less than mode. So that is left skewed distribution. So in conclusion, before we conclude whether the type of distribution is either left skewed, right skewed, or symmetrical, you need to have these three information, these three values. First is mean, second is median, and the third one is a mode. Okay. So, we also have exercise 2.2, okay. So, do this and later on we will discuss in our online class. So, that's all for measures of central tendency.
Thank you.